Hi guys, Martha Farrell here from Poughkeepsie Public Library, and I'm here to show you how to make rock candy with a few simple ingredients. All you need is sugar, water, and some food coloring if you like, a couple of jars, and a spoon. You'll also need a pencil with a string attached, or two clothespins and a stick attached. I'll tell you more about that later. The first thing you want to do is take 3 cups of sugar and pour it into a pot. Then you'll need 1 cup of water. Pour that into the pot. Then take your spoon and stir it up. All right, then turn on your heat. I think I'll put it on 5, nice medium heat. And we're gonna wait for this sugar water mixture to come to a boil. As my mixture heats, I'm gonna stir it occasionally. I don't want it to burn. You don't have to stir constantly, but don't leave the room either. Stay with it. It'll happen. Stir it once in a while. All right, now you can see the mixture has come to a boil. We don't want it to boil for a long time because then it won't work. So I'm going to take it off the heat and let that cool for a minute. Okay, what is rock candy without a little food coloring? I don't have the regular kind of food coloring that you may have. For some reason I have this weird stuff. It comes in a gel. But I'm going to try it. So I'm going to make blue and put a few drops of blue in my jar. And red. Put a few drops of red food coloring in my jar. Then I'm going to take my sugar syrup that I made and pour it into each jar. Perfect. Okay. Then I'm going to stir it up a little bit. Make sure it's nice and stirred. Now, there's 2 methods of making your rock candy. One is the stick method, and one is the string method. But it's important before you start to wet down your string or your stick with that sugar syrup. I'm going to do that and cut back to you. Okay, what I've done is tied a plain, regular piece of string around a pencil, and then I dipped it in my sugar syrup, and now I'm going to dip it in a little bit of sugar so we can get the crystals started growing. The crystals will need something to grab onto. And then I'm going to dip the string right into my liquid here. Hopefully that'll go down eventually. I'll give it a little poke later. And here's my popsicle stick, and it's being supported by 2 clothespins. I'm going to dip that in the sugar too. All right, now I have my popsicle stick that I dipped in the sugar syrup and then in the plain sugar. And you can see it has sugar crystals stuck to it. So I'm going to put that into the jar as well. I found I had to put a little knot at the end of my string to make it heavy enough to sink. You don't want the string touching the sides of the jar or the bottom. So I think I'm pretty good here. The reason I'm using two clothespins for this is that I found when I used one, I'll show you. It kept falling in. That was frustrating. So two clothespins was my ingenious idea to make this work. Now really, that's about all there is to it for now, and we're going to let it set on my windowsill for a couple of days, and we'll see that sugar crystals are starting to form, and I'll show you that later. Now we've reached day 7. These rock candy jars have been sitting for 7 days. I showed you how the red one progressed, so I'm going to take that one out right now. And I'm going to put it on some parchment paper to dry. The blue one I haven't touched. I thought this would be a different experiment. I'm going to break up the sugar that's crust that's on the top here. Hope this works. Needs a little more breaking up. All right, here we go. I broke it up. That one came out pretty well too. That's the blue rock candy, the red rock candy. Once it's dried out a little bit, you can eat it. Brush your teeth afterwards though.